I wish the crackle from the flame lasted a bit longer. I'm going to be brushing the mics today. This was a request, suggestion from Comforting Sounds ASMR. And I've been wanting to do a sort of a catch-up video, just chatting about my life recently, and so I thought this might be a good combination. I might do some tapping as well. I'm not sure. We'll see where my whimsy takes me. But I've just got a nice candle for us to look at. You're well. And if you're not doing so well right now, then please have an extra hug from me, okay? Same old brush. Just gently. So I've got quite a few things to talk about. I hope you're ready to chuck this on, perhaps while you do something else. Just relax. I like to listen to ASMR while I play my Switch. Discuss areas of mental health. I'm going to talk about things that have not been so great, as well as things that I'm excited about. I try and find a balance between being real and sharing my struggles as part of being human, but without just being depressing and dragging you down. So, this last week has been pretty overwhelming for me. Good parts and unpleasant parts, but I'm constantly learning and growing. Things are allowed to be unpleasant for a while. It's a part of life. to entire days where I did mental health first aid training. So I guess you could say it's similar to regular first aid, but for matters of mental health and mental illnesses. How to support people if they're not doing so great. How to assist in a crisis. And there was lots covered. And it was really, really good. And I'm really glad I did this training. And I'll get a accreditation, I think that's the word, for it. But as you can imagine, we did not shy away from topics, we delved deeply into them. And I won't talk about all of the heavy stuff right now. But at the end of the first day, I was quite emotional, and I overestimated my ability to be untouched. And I do that often. I am a deeply, deeply empathetic person, and I absorb the world around me. So, I cannot hope to be unaffected. But again, it's okay. I just had to take care of myself and work through it. And the second day, it was better in the aspects of my own awkwardness. I felt more comfortable. I think on the first day I was trying to overcompensate a lot. I find it very difficult to know how to speak in a group. The ebb and flow of conversation, I find it very hard to know when there's a good opening, and it seems like everyone else just does it so well. So most of the time I tend to not talk so much, but I felt that I had things to say, and so I ended up interrupting people a lot. I didn't mean to. Anyway, but I was a bit surprised. I was caught off guard by a particular topic, and I'm going to add a little trigger warning in here for you. I'm not going to go into a lot of detail, but I'll be talking about eating disorders, okay? I'll put up a timestamp that you can skip to. So there's a thing called binge eating disorder, and I didn't really know about it, and the symptoms and the behaviors and the and I realized that I probably had at one point if not still in some way, this particular condition. And you may know I've talked about my health journey over the past almost year at this point. And so that's been going okay. It's not been going very well the last few months, but in the period before I started my health journey, I fit all the criteria. Like I said, I'm not going to go into it, but it was just quite a shock to my emotional system. And thankfully we had lunch break right after, and I went out to my car and just started to cry. And I called my friend, and she was really great. She just stayed with me on the phone for like half an hour because I was grieving. I was grieving the help that I could have had and didn't know that I could have had help. And I've had a few days to let it settle, and I've, I'm not like shaken up by it anymore, but it was just a lot to process. Anyway, so I was late back to into the class, I guess, and I thought that's fine, I'm gonna take a little bit of extra time. I went into the loos and like splashed my face with water, but there was absolutely no doubt that I had been crying. My face, my cheeks, eyes, my nose, they were all just red. It was really nice. The teacher, I guess, when everyone else was occupied, he came over to me and asked if we'd like, if I'd like to step outside and just chat. And it was really great. He was just really lovely and took care of me. And I stayed and did the rest of the training, and I was proud of myself. I was proud of myself for walking back into that class with, you know, a red face. And anyway, so over the weekend, I did a lot of self-care, and I've just been taking it easy. That's the end of that topic, I think. I've got a pretty busy week coming up as well. So the next 2 days, tomorrow, the day after, I actually have like initial meet and greet meetings with a couple of potential clients. I have started my own little business as a disability support worker, in case you didn't. So, this is pretty exciting, a potential opportunity to gain some more clients. But I'm very, very nervous, and I need to prepare. It is currently like 6 p.m. and my appointment, my first appointment, is tomorrow morning. So I have this evening to prepare. Need to get my paperwork in order and write out a list of things that I need to discuss with this person tomorrow, things that we need to come to an agreement on, and just suss out whether we will fit well together. And then I have another one the next day as well with someone different. So it's super exciting, but super nerve-wracking. Wanted a bit of a reprieve from the brushing sounds. I find it difficult, because I can't, I don't have headphones on, so I can't actually hear what the brushing sounds like, but also I don't love the sound personally myself. I don't hate it, but I don't love it. So, in cases like that, I find it hard to edit, because I don't know if it sounds good or not. So I just have to try my best. But I know that I can get a bit overwhelmed, sensory overwhelm, I guess. A sound goes on for too long sometimes, especially when it's right in my ears. So I've also got a few things that I am looking forward to. So, in my area, so not the state that I live in, but the smaller area within the state that I live in. Every winter, there's a winter festival, and it goes over the course of a month or so, June and July, and it's really fun. I love winter time, and especially because here Christmas time is in the summer, so we don't get that magical wintry Christmas, so it's just nice to have some sort of winter celebration. And there's one event in particular. So it's all different local businesses and organizations and such hosting different events, and sometimes it's just the council, I guess. So this one event in particular that me and my friend are very excited about, and it's in a few weeks, and it is a medieval bonfire night, and we're encouraged to dress up in costume. We were planning on going last year, but didn't end up going. And we didn't have costumes either, because we kind of left it too late. But we got on it early this year. So we both ordered dresses online, and hers has arrived already, and it looks so good. Like, it's always tricky buying stuff online, like, it's risky, but hers fits. And mine is yet to arrive. I would definitely love to get some photos to show you of the event, you know, and of me dressed up. My dress is sort of a more common, like a common folk type of dress, like someone who works in a tavern, say. And then my friend's dress is like very royal, like a queen's medieval dress. So the whole event goes for like 6 hours, and it starts with a market, and then there'll be people doing like reenactment stuff, which is really cool, and they're gonna have a big bonfire and a spit roast. And it's just exciting because we don't really have like any opportunities to do that sort of thing here. I know that Renaissance fairs are a thing in America and probably other places, but we just don't have them here, so the chance to dress up and celebrate is fun. I also have a little holiday planned, which I'm very excited about. This is in, I'll be going end of July, end of next month. And I'll be going with one of my brothers to one of my favorite places. Down in Tasmania. Tasmania is the island state that's like right down the bottom of Australia. It's like the little triangular kind of island. So we'll be going for a few days, and I haven't had the chance to go there in a few years now. The last time was for my friend's wedding in like pre-COVID. I'm super, super excited about that, and I'm sure I'll keep you updated. And I'll have lots of photos. It's my favorite place. So, the last thing that I wanted to just talk about a little bit it's another thing that I'm excited about. It feels novel to have so many things that I'm looking forward to. And this one is in about 3 months. But this might not sound super exciting, but for me it is. I have an appointment to have an assessment done for autism. An autism assessment. And it's exciting because I've been like on the waiting list to get into this place for over a year. And just recently, they let me know that they are making appointments. Like they've opened up their book. Their book. I don't know what I mean by that, but their bookings. I know. Like, there's a big part of me that's really terrified that I'm gonna go through all of this effort and money. It's very expensive. Just to be told that I'm not actually autistic. But I feel like I am. And I know it probably doesn't seem obvious. But I've been on quite a self-discovery journey this last year, and it's making more and more sense to me. And if I am, and if I get like a diagnosis, then it's going to mean a lot as far as opportunities go. Like, especially employment opportunities. And this, I've been waiting for this particular place because it specializes in it specializes in like diagnosing and supporting autistic women and girls. The fact that this place specializes in females and also adults is really great because it means that they're not just going to go off the like stereotypical criteria. I'm hoping that they will be able to look through I don't know, like the masks, I guess, and see through the gaps. I don't know, I don't think I'm making much sense, but yeah, I'm pretty excited. So that's in 3 months, and then it's another month until I receive the report. So 4 months. Well, that was everything. If you have listened to even just a part of this, then thank you very much. You're so appreciated. And I thank you for your support. And I hope that, I don't know, my goal is to just create a realness and an openness on this channel. And I just want to show just the humanness of myself, the ups and downs, in the hopes that it can be helpful in some way. Just creating this atmosphere, this community of humanity, humanness. And I want you to know you're not alone, and you can talk to me anytime. I have an email, which I'll put in the description, and it's also in my, bio. Or just, you're welcome to chat in the comments. And if you thought that you would be okay, with the trigger warning and everything, and then it turned out that maybe you're not coping so well, then please reach out for support from your loved ones, or from a helpline of some sort. Do a little Google search and I'm sure something will come up. Well, like I said, you're welcome to send me an email. And that goes for all of you as well. If you just want to chat and discuss something, whatever. My point is that I'm here. Also, what did you think of the mic brushing? Was it pleasant? Like I said, I find it hard to tell. Found this relaxing in some way. And I hope you know that I love you very much. Night, my loves. I'll see you later.